Greetings. The Bridegroom Cometh. Jesus said, "No man knows the day or hour when the Bridegroom cometh." Jesus talked about 10 virgins looking for when the Bridegroom cometh. Let's read through Matthew 24, beginning verse 36. "But of that day and hour no one knows, not even the angels of heaven nor the Son, but the Father alone." Knows is a word with present tense. "For the coming of the Son of Man will be just like the days of Noah. For as in those days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered the ark. And they did not understand, until the flood came and took them all away. So will the coming of the Son of Man be. Then there will be two men in the field, one will be taken and one will be left. Two women will be grinding at the mill, one will be taken and one will be left. Therefore be on the alert, for you do not know which day your Lord is coming." Not knowing is not an excuse to not pay attention. The exact opposite. Watch every day as if that might be the day, because you don't know the day. But be sure of this, that if the head of the house had known at what time of the night the thief was coming, he would have been on the alert and would not have allowed his house to be broken into. Be sure of this. To know is to be more responsible. For this reason, you also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour when you do not think he will. Now, don't let some foolish idea misread that statement. You cannot stop his coming by thinking he will come at a certain hour. Who then is the faithful and sensible slave whom his master put in charge of his household to give them their food at the proper time? Blessed is that slave whom his master finds so doing when he comes. Make no mistake, the master is coming back. You should be alert so he finds you doing what he's called you to do. Truly I say to you that he will put him in charge of all his possessions. But if that evil slave says in his heart, "My master is not coming for a long time," think about this. How is this slave different from the mockers? 2 Peter 3:3. "Know this first of all, that in the last days mockers will come with their mocking, following after their own lusts, and saying, 'Where is the promise of his coming? For ever since the fathers fell asleep, all continues just as it was from the beginning of creation,' and begins to beat his fellow slaves and eat and drink with drunkards, this slave abuses his authority. The master of that slave will come on a day when he does not expect him, and at an hour when he does not know." This is just a coincidence, right? Jesus speaking of the day and hour. "And will cut him in pieces and assign him a place with the hypocrites. In that place there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." Oops, he didn't see that coming, I guess. "Then the kingdom of heaven will be comparable to 10 virgins, who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were prudent. For when the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them." Keep in mind, even the foolish were looking. "But the prudent took oil in flasks along with their lamps. Now, while the bridegroom was delaying, they all got drowsy and began to sleep." He's doing something. We just don't know what. "But at midnight, there was a shout, 'Behold, the bridegroom! Come out to meet him!'" Please, don't extrapolate this to mean Jesus will come midnight Jerusalem time. "Then all those virgins rose and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the prudent, 'Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out.' But the prudent answered, "No, there will not be enough for us and you too. Go instead to the dealers and buy some for yourselves." From this, I gather your relationship is individual with the bridegroom. Each must make their own preparations. And while they were going away to make their purchases, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding feast, and the door was shut. Later, the other virgins also came, saying, "Lord, Lord, open up for us." But he answered, "Truly I say to you, I do not know you." Reading Matthew 25:12, another passage comes to mind. Matthew 7:22, "Many will say to me on that day, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, and in your name cast out demons, and in your name perform many miracles?' And then I will declare to them, 'I never knew you. Depart from me, you who practice lawlessness.'" In Matthew 25:12, Jesus is teaching about the bridegroom. In Matthew 7:22 and 23, Jesus says, "Say to me on that day, 'Lord, Lord,' then I will declare, 'I never knew you.'" Clearly, Jesus is Lord, Lord, and Jesus is the bridegroom who comes in the night. Be on the alert then, for you do not know the day nor the hour. Not knowing the day and hour should be a motivator, not an excuse. I also find it interesting that twice people approach Jesus with, "Lord, Lord," and both times his rebuke is him not knowing you. Matthew 25:12, "Truly I say to you, I do not know you." Matthew 7:23, "And then I will declare to them, I never knew you." As I meditate on that, I try to not invert it. Jesus did not say, "You don't know me." And honestly, that hair-lips my own dogma a bit. Does Jesus really mean to say, "You never allowed me to be intimate with you"? Not in some sick, twisted way, but did you open your heart to Jesus? Have you allowed him to truly bypass your guards and your defenses? I think now is the time to be real with Jesus. So real that it hurts your pride to do so. So real that it humbles your heart before God. None of us can make it through the days ahead by ourselves. But each of us is responsible to let him know us. The bridegroom cometh. I pray you are alert and ready for his appearing. The bridegroom cometh. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, the bridegroom. Amen.